Hi everybody, my name's Tony and I'm part of the Everyday Counts program. Thank you for joining me. We have an hour together for chair yoga. And today's focus is mindful moving from the inside out. So listening to yourself, listening to your body, and figuring out what feels best for you. Make sure that you have a chair that's stable and steady, and that you've got a little bit of space around you so you're not bumping yourself. I'm gonna sit away from the back of my chair. If you need or feel more comfortable with the support of the back of your chair, then go ahead. All these little choices are the same thing that I just spoke about. It's about knowing the options and choosing for yourself. There's no right and wrong here. There's no way this should be done. There's no way it needs to look. This is about really deciding for yourself and choosing what feels right to you in this moment. Not necessarily what you did last week, but this moment. So from here, making sure your feet are a comfortable distance for you. If our knees are above our ankles, then it gives us a little bit more stability than if our feet are out in front or underneath us. So you could check that out too. Picking up the toes, or even imagining any of this movement. You can pick up the balls of the feet if you like, wiggle those toes around a little bit, and then see if you can fan them out, broaden as wide as possible, feeling the soles of your feet widen and lengthen through the toes too. And then with that, take the feet all the way down to the floor. So you're noticing the support underneath you. From here, you're welcome to soften or lower your gaze or even close your eyes if you're comfortable doing that. We'll take a big breath in. Exhale it out. Another two or three breaths, just like that, allowing the exhale to release tension and tightness, allowing your week or your day to slide away from your shoulders, and starting to give yourself permission to be here in this moment. Allow the breath to settle back to its own normal rhythm, as natural a breath as comes to you. And then take your awareness all the way down to the soles of your feet once again. Without needing to change a thing, simply notice the connection of your feet down to the support underneath them. Notice the places in the soles of your feet that feel more connected, and then the places that feel less connected downwards. And then make any micro movements or adjustments you need to broaden that connection through the entire sole of your foot. So maybe shifting your weight out or in, forward or back, and see if you can spread your awareness through the soles of your feet and the soles of your feet spreading to connect to as much surface as possible. Again, there's no right and wrong way of doing this. Most of this is subtle awareness. Allow the weight of your legs to rest into that support. And notice if you're resisting that support in some way. And then gather your awareness from the soles of your feet up through your legs into where your seat meets the chair. And just place your awareness there very much like you did with the soles of your feet. Not needing to change a thing, just notice. Notice the tension, the tightness. And then if you want to, shift, move adjust yourself to what feels best from the inside to you. Noticing if you're sitting more to one side than the other, more forward, more back, and you get to play around with all of that. And again, this is just building up subtle awarenesses. We sit down a lot during the day. So this is just building our awareness to how we are actually in that seat. There's a lot going on around us that we're not paying attention to at any given moment. And that's also okay. We don't want to be paying attention to our seat when we're in conversation with somebody. We're present with the conversation, but this is just building up subtle awarenesses. And then allow your upper body to rest into the weight of the chair. Softening and releasing any muscles that you feel were tightening. So our seat and our feet are connected downwards. And then through the spine, lifting up through each vertebrae, up all the way to the base of the skull, crown of the head reaching towards the sky as if someone picked you up by a thread. There's a lengthening there. So just notice that connection downwards, the rooting to rise, the lengthening, that duality. Allow the shoulders to soften away from the ears and settle. Hands supported if that's comfortable. And then broaden through the collarbones just a little. Not so much so that you're jamming anything back, but just so there's an opening throughout the chest. Allow the muscles of your face to soften, your expression to drift off. Take a breath in, a full breath, all the way to the top of your breath in your own way. Exhale like a sigh, keeping the alignment but relaxing the tightness. And you can do that a couple of times. So we keep our seat, we keep our awareness to our seat, but we take the tension out of it as best as we can. And then draw your awareness inwards and just connect with yourself today. Notice how you're feeling and what's going on with you today. No judgment, just be aware. Just the awareness to everything that arises. Notice any inner dialogue, any stories. Notice if that inner dialogue, if there is any, is gentle and kind. And if not, is there anything you can do to shift that, to even be more neutral? Notice how your physical body is feeling today from the soles of your feet. And with that awareness we built up there, you might even feel a energy there, a buzzing, a humming, all the way up to the crown of your head, taking in your body as a whole, noticing sensation. And try not to label sensation as good or bad, but just awake and alive to it all. And then allow your awareness to settle in different parts of your body where you're drawn to. Probably starting off with the familiar places, the places that you have big stories attached to. But also place your awareness in other areas that you may not not usually pay attention to. Notice the sensations there. Always giving yourself permission to adjust your body, to move, to shift as you need to. Turning your palms up on either the arms of your chair or your legs. This is traditionally for receiving, being open to everything that is present. Bringing your presence into this moment. And we do that simply by being aware of all those small things, the soles of your feet, how your body feels. Moment to moment awareness. Starting to notice your breath just as it is. And noticing if you could bring your breath in and out through your nose comfortably. Allowing the lips to softly come together. And if that is not comfortable for you, no big deal. Nostril breathing is one of the easiest, quickest ways we can reduce the stress response. We come out of that elevated stress response that so many of us live in, and our awareness starts to expand. So if that is something that you want to explore, then go ahead. In and out through the nose. Staying at your natural, easy rhythm, or inviting in a little deeper breath on the inhale, a little longer breath on the exhale. Not to any point of strain at all. So stay within a breath that feels sustainable and easy for you. We all breathe differently and our breath changes all the time. So again, staying with that neutral mind. Letting go of stories, certainly letting go of inner dialogue that is not compassionate. Noticing how you speak to yourself. The relationship we have with ourselves is the longest relationship we will have in this entire lifetime. So what would it mean for you to befriend yourself? To speak to yourself as if you were a beloved friend. Smoothing and steadying out those breaths as best as you can. If you want to, even having a visual of the breath starting around the lower belly, and on the inhale, drawing up through the spine like a traditional thermometer would, and on the exhale, settling down. That doesn't have to come up very high. Maybe it simply comes up to your solar plexus and down. Maybe it comes up through the crown of your head. Imagining, sensing, or feeling that breath. And if that is not for you either, then simply a steadier breath as you can allow. Allow the exhale to be just as steady as the inhale. Even listening to the sound of that breath as it comes in and out. And then with this breath, allow any forcing, any tightness, either in your body, your mind, your energy, to relax and release. And if that means shifting and changing your body, then go ahead. Going to move with the breath, starting with our fingers, So on the inhale, stretching those soft hands out to reach through the fingers and the thumbs. So we stretch across the palms of the hands. And on the exhale, we're going to curl those fingers and thumbs in towards each other. Any amount. Inhaling, reaching through the fingers and the thumbs. Exhaling, curling. Inhaling and exhaling. This does not have to be a big movement. You do not have to take those fingers all the way into a curled fist. Again, allow your breath to be the guide here. So it doesn't have to look a particular way. We're just simply moving with the breath, inhaling and exhaling. And maybe you notice that there is more energy in one part of the movement than the other, just being curious, not needing to unpack it or understand it, just following the movement with the breath. And maybe you are drawn to a bigger movement, stretching through the fingers and thumbs on the inhale and curling in a little tighter on the exhale. Or maybe that feels like too much effort. Go inside, keeping your eyes lowered, soft or closed if you'd like to. And notice the point that it starts to feel like effort. Allow the movement between the top of the inhale and the bottom of the exhale to be as smooth as you can allow your breath to be. Got another couple of breaths here. One more in your own time. And you can always stay here for longer. After the next exhale, allow your hands to open to a place that they feel natural. No forcing, no efforting whatsoever. And notice the stillness. Staying as you are, or lifting your hands up from the support. We're going to be circling through the wrists now. Start small. Allow your hands to be in that place of neutrality to start with. You might notice places in the circling of the wrists that are more challenging than others. Give yourself permission to shift and change the movement so it feels the most easy, the most natural for you. And that might mean turning your elbows out, your forearms down. You might want them down beside you. That might feel easier for you. You get to choose. Steady breath. Awareness of what this feels like from the inside. And again, the choice of making those movements bigger, smaller. You want to change up something through your fingers, maybe bringing them into soft fists, maybe keeping them neutral and easy, maybe reaching through those fingers and thumbs. And then when you're ready, the end of an exhale, whenever that is for you, we'll pause and take it round in the opposite direction. Eyes soft, lowered, or closed. Noticing what you notice. Noticing thoughts that come up. That inner dialogue, memories. Just be aware of anything and everything in this moment. Rest if you need to. end of the next exhale, pause and bring your hands back to a comfortable position. And notice as you do that how the rest of your body responds to that stillness. Steady breaths in and out through the nose if that's comfy. From here, taking the right hand out in front of you as if you're going to stop somebody, and you can have a bent elbow or not. This is the inhale, fingertips coming back towards you. So we're reaching through the wrist here, and on an exhale, I'm going to take those fingers down, curling them back towards you. Inhaling and exhaling. And if you want to do this with your hand lower, go ahead. Feels good to you. That inhale, we're reaching not only through the wrist but through the fingers and to the tips of the thumb. Noticing how that feels for you. Noticing if doing less feels better. You can always support that upper arm, or again, have that arm low. Another couple. Neutral. And from here you can take your hand out just so you can see it as if you were laying it on a table. Again, elbow bent or stretched, your turn, your choice. And then we're just going to shift the wrist from side to side. And I can already see my elbow is moving. So if you cup the elbow, and then we're just shifting the hand. I'm going to show it like that, hand from side to side. As if you're shifting it on the surface of a table, getting through the wrist side to side. And then when you're ready, resting that down. Left hand comes out, and just simply mirroring you. This is the inhale, fingertips come back, exhaling, turning that wrist down, fingertips draw towards your armpit, inhaling and exhaling. Not overthinking what's going on anywhere, just simply flexing and extending. Again, that hand can be down. You know, notice as you bring the hand down that you have a little different range of motion. One is not better than the other, you just get to decide. You get to decide whether it feels comfy, doing less or more, or resting. And then from there, taking the hand to that flat, imagined flat surface, elbow can be in. We're just sliding the wrist from side to side. If you want to cup that elbow, so the elbow is neutral, so the movement is coming from the wrist rather than the upper arm, then you can go ahead and do that. Notice as you do that if your hand is tipping one way or another, keep it, see if you can keep it on that flat surface. Take that hand down. Any movement you need to, go ahead. And then from there, I'm going to take the hands out in front of you. Pinky fingers towards each other, palms to the ceiling. From there, I'm going to turn to the side so you can see me. Keeping the hands connected, I'm going to draw the palms in towards you. Roll over the back of the hands, taking the palms out as we stretch and open the thumbs up. I know it seems a bit more complicated. So, drawing it in towards you, rolling over the back of the hands so the palms turn down, reach, and then open up through the palms. So at all times, the hands are connected. Drawing them in towards you, rolling over the back of the hands, and opening up through the palms. Mm-hmm. And it might take you a little while to get that. Inhaling and exhaling in your own natural way, steady movement. There's a whole lot going on in the hands, the wrists. Now we're bringing the elbows and the shoulders involved too, trying to keep that as neutral and steady as you like. And if you want to bring the hands down further, then you can. Again, you get to adjust this movement so it feels better for you. Inhaling and exhaling, gentle. Soften the gaze, close the eyes once you have the movement. Notice where you're feeling this. Couple in this direction, and then we'll go around in the opposite direction. Palms up, and then we're going around in the opposite direction, so palms towards each other, back of the hands, and we're opening out. Palms towards each other, down, back of the hands. Breath steady, the movement flowing within the smoothness of the breath. Another two. To dangle down, releasing. Arms are heavy, and we're drawing circles through the shoulders. Steady breath, steady movement. Allowing your breath to guide the movement. Noticing how this feels through the shoulders. And then back in the opposite direction. Again, steady breath, steady movement, lowered or softened gaze, closed eyes, your choice. Adjusting and adapting things, one last one. And then we rest, hands come back to support. Go inside and simply notice how you feel. Notice your energy through your fingertips all the way through your shoulders, and anywhere else you may feel it. Notice the steady breath. Notice the thoughts, the inner dialogue. Be gentle with yourself. Rooting feet and seat to rise up, steady, smooth breath. On the inhale, lifting the chin. On the exhale, drawing the chin down towards your chest. If you feeling any dizziness, then open your eyes, softly fix your gaze somewhere in front of you and keep your eyes steady on at that point. Otherwise, whatever feels good to you. On the inhale, when you lift the chin, think about reaching through the back of the neck as well, so it's not so compressed towards the top of your shoulders. Notice how that shifts and changes things. Stay within a place that feels effortless. Notice if your go-to is to go to the furthest range of motion you possibly can, regardless of how that feels. And if that feels good for you, then fantastic. And if it doesn't, give yourself permission to do less. If you want to stay in one particular place because that feels really good, go ahead. Last one, and we'll come back to neutral after the exhale. Coming up to center. This is now the inhale. On the exhale, turning to one side, inhaling to center, exhaling, turning to the other side. Movements coming from the collarbones upwards. So everything from the collarbones downwards stays as neutral as possible. Notice as you look to one side if the opposite shoulder wants to creep forward. Again, just awareness to all the subtleties of the movement. Giving yourself permission to change things up, to move in a way that serves you, that you're working with your body. Noticing if you're keeping your chin parallel to the floor, if it's shifting when you come to one side or the other. One more either side. Coming back to center. Rooting down to rise. If you're sitting into the back of your chair, you may want to come forward as we're getting into seated cat and cow. So shifting to in your own way. On the inhale, hands resting on your legs. Heart comes forward, shoulder blades slide towards each other as the elbows and hands draw back. Exhaling, pushing the fingertips towards or on the knees as the belly button draws back. Inhaling and exhaling. Flexion and extension through the spine in your own way. Again, we've already been here. On the inhale, you can lift the chin. On the exhale, you can draw the chin in towards the chest. Notice what feels good for you. And coming down into the lower belly on the inhale, sending that tailbone out behind you. So sitting to the forward of your pelvis, resting your weight more on the top of your thighs. And on the exhale, sitting into at the back. So you're tucking the tail here, rolling maybe onto the back of the pelvis somewhat. Noticing the steadiness of the movement. Noticing where it feels comfortable for you and where it feels challenging. Allow the breath to guide the steady movement. Notice everything that arises. Changing it up. If you want to stay in one place and breathe, then you can go ahead and do that. If there's another movement that arises that you just are drawn to, go ahead, give yourself permission. Learning to listen to our body and notice what it needs, even within the gentle movements. Mm-hmm.
few breaths here.
Coming back to center. Once again, going inside, soften the gaze, lower the gaze, close the eyes, and notice the energy in your body. Notice your breath. Notice your relationship and your connection to your body. Your feelings, your mind, your whole self. And from here, I'm going to be coming down on the floor. You can do everything we're doing from the chair if you wish to stay. Moving through all of the joints. You can adapt everything to the chair. Everything we're going to be doing, okay? So for those of you who wish to stay in the chair, go ahead. Otherwise, I'm going to see you down on the floor. Bring with you everything you need to finish up your practice that you need for relaxation. And from here, coming all the way down onto our back. Knees to the sky, feet to the floor. Take any softness you need to underneath you. Rearrange yourself so it feels as comfortable as possible. And if you need extra support underneath your head to bring it up because that feels more comfortable for you, any adjustments you need, give yourself permission to. And then we settle in. Notice the steadiness of the breath as you settle. Soft gaze or closed eyes. And settle back in with that connection into your body, expanding your awareness into your whole body. Heel-toeing your ankles into a comfortable distance, and maybe hip distance, maybe closer. From here, rooting down through the left leg, hovering the right foot. With an ease to the movement, guided by the gentle flow of the breath, inhaling, extending the right leg towards straight, doesn't have to get straight, exhaling, curling the heel back down, inhaling and exhaling. You can rest in between. Again, allow the breath to guide the movement. So the inhale is extending the leg as much as you want to, exhaling, curling, keeping the ankle neutral, so neither flexed or extended itself. Noticing how the breath guides the movement. Notice if doing a little more effort feels better for you, reaching through the heel, drawing the toes back, or not. What your intention is, whether it's guiding the movement with the breath, aware to everything that arises, whether you want to get length through the back of that right leg. Inhaling and exhaling. One more. And then we take the right foot all the way down to the floor, readjust. Notice the stillness after the movement. And then rooting down through the right foot, the left foot hovers. When you're ready, inhaling, extending, exhaling, drawing down.
keeping that left ankle neutral, unless you want to push the heel up towards the sky and that feels good for you. That'll change up the sensation. No right and wrong here. We're just guiding the movement with the breath and awake and aware of everything that arises. Not only in the left leg, the left knee, but the rest of the body too. We've got one more to go, more or less, and then we'll draw the left heel down and foot comes to the floor. Right knee draws in. Give yourself a little hug here. Excellent place to be right here. You have a few options. You can keep the left knee as it is. You can wing the left knee out to the left and come to the outer blade of that left foot if you like. You can extend the left leg long. And if there's a hybrid you want to do supporting that left thigh with a bolster, with a block, you can go ahead and do that too. Right hand, right knee. Right knee comes up towards the sky and we're circling through the hip joint. One circle to one cycle of breath. And if your knee is, the left knee is bent and out towards the side, that can counteract the right knee drawing out towards the right. You get to decide what feels good. If you don't need the hand on the knee, arms can come in a cactus or a T. The steadiness of the movement is the focus here, guided by the breath. Again, choosing from the inside what feels right to you. An add-on from here. Whichever direction you're going in, you can start to extend the leg down towards the bottom of the mat. And so the knee draws up towards the chest and then it lengthens out a little, not straightening at any point. That's going to increase sensation. And again, you get to choose from the inside out what feels right to you. And then when you're ready, we'll pause and go around in the opposite direction, starting small, and maybe that hand cups the knee to begin with. It doesn't matter which direction you are doing, we all do our favorite direction first. And then the option is to release that leg to do its own bidding, or maybe you like the stability of the hand on the knee. You can extend that right leg out a little longer as the heel comes down towards the lower end of your mat. Adjusting and adapting the movement for your body. Another couple here, unless you've rested already, listening to your body and what it needs. Next time the knee comes in towards you, give that knee a little hug. And from here, we're circling through the ankle. One direction. And then when you're ready, as slow and as steady as makes sense to you, back in the opposite direction. Awareness to your ankle. back to center now. Allowing that ankle to be soft, but fanning out through the right toes. And then on the exhale, curling the toes in. Inhaling, spreading them wide as possible. Curling them in, letting that ankle be neutral. The movement is coming from and through the toes and the ball of the foot. Very much like when we were opening and closing our hands. And then from there, allow the movement to get softer and easier. Giving yourself permission to do less. And if that feels better in stillness, then go ahead and do that. Giving yourself permission to do what it is that you need, what feels right for you. One more in your own time. Bringing the foot to a complete neutral place. Resting the right foot back on the floor and bringing the left foot to meet it if it's not there already. Go inwards, soften the gaze, close the eyes if you feel comfortable, breathing slowly and steadily in through the nose. And notice the difference between the right leg and the left leg. Left knee draws in. Give it a little hug. You can stay here with the right leg coming to the outer blade of the foot. You can extend that right leg out, whatever feels comfortable. Left hand, left knee, and the knee draws up. And then we start to circle through the hip. So circling with the knee, hand on the knee. Noticing how that feels. How does that feel from the inside? If you could give yourself permission to do anything, what would it be to feel as if you were working with your body here? You can keep that hand on the knee, you can release the hand so the leg or the knee circles in its own way, but the awareness here is through the left hip. You can extend that heel away from you, lengthening a little bit more through that hip joint. And this may or may not feel good for you, so you get to choose. How does it feel from the inside? Aware to everything, sensation, thoughts, feelings. Not only in that hip, but through the rest of your body too. Another couple in this direction. If you're not resting already, we'll come to rest. And then maybe hand back to that knee to draw around in the opposite direction just to get used to it. A little bit of stability there. And then the option is to release the hand, to start extending that leg out in your own time. Notice your breath. Notice how the breath is responding in harmony to the movement. If you need to change the movement for the breath to be more comfortable, what would feel more effortless here? Smooth and steady. Two more. Bringing the knee up and in, giving it a little hug. And then then circling through the left ankle in one direction. And it might not feel super smooth, no big deal, no judgment. We're just noticing, we're steadying the breath, steadying the movement along with it. And when you're ready, we'll pause and go around in the opposite direction. Is there anything you can do to make it more effortless here? Stillness, allowing your ankle to be soft and flowing with your breath on the inhale, fanning the toes out, exhaling, curling them in. And rather than going to the biggest movement of all, blend the harmony of the movement with the smooth and steadiness of the breath. Allow yourself to do less. And allow that less to turn over the next couple of breaths into stillness. Notice how that feels. Left foot comes to the floor in your own time. Right foot comes back to meet it. And then we'll heel toe the feet wide towards the outside edges of your mat. Arms in a cactus or a T, whatever's comfortable for you, rooting down through the shoulders. This is the inhale and the exhale. We're just softening the knees to one side. Inhale to center and exhale over to the other side. So as if there's a gentle breeze washing your knees from side to side. Keeping it easy, gentle. Noticing that gentle massage on the back of your pelvis. Excellent place to stay right here. If you're drawn to it, your knees can come further towards one side as the opposite hip lifts a little. Shoulders and head are connected downwards though. The movement is coming from the lower body, bringing a soft or a deeper twist up through the spine. Noticing this in your hips. If this doesn't feel good in your lower back, your SI joint, then please keep it as neutral, as soft as possible. If you want to bring the knees all the way down to one side and gaze over the opposite shoulder, you can do that now, taking a few steady breaths. Resting on one side, you can draw your knees up to center and go over to the other side if that feels good to you. And one side may feel very different from the other, so honoring that. Steady breaths. And when you're ready, coming all the way back up to center. Ankles go wide, knees come in towards each other, stillness. staying here, or if there's any other movement you want to finish off your practice, maybe giving yourself a little hug, curling your knees in, if you're on the chair, one knee at a time. And when you're ready, coming to a place that you want to finish your practice in relaxation, whatever that looks like to you, it doesn't matter.
And as you settle yourself in, connecting downwards, maybe adding layers, eye pillows, and when you're ready, taking a breath in, a deep breath in, exhale it out like a soft sigh. Three more of those, or take a breath all the way to the top and hold the breath, but release the tension in your body. Take another breath in all the way to the top. Hold again, release the tension. Last sip of breath in. Exhale, let it all go as you let your body settle down into that support. Noticing, just like we did at the beginning, the support underneath you and all the places your body is touching that support. Release into it. Releasing your whole body downwards. Releasing effort. And releasing thoughts, tension and tightness start to dissolve and drain away. Giving yourself permission to soften from the inside out, as if the very core of you were a little warmer and a little softer. And like warm liquid that melts outwards through your torso, shoulders and hips. Neck and head, shoulders, all the way down to the tips of your fingers, from your hips all the way down your legs to the tips of your toes. Releasing and relaxing from the inside out. You may notice different tension drawing inwards and tightening. And as you notice, release it as best as you can. From the inside out, as that tension builds, allow it to dissolve as it comes into your awareness. notice the steady breath. Notice your body responding to the breath with gentle, soft movements. Working in harmony together. Stay just as you are for as long as you like, or over the next few moments, starting to increase that inhale, allow the exhale to come out like a soft sigh. Making any soft movements, gentle awakening movements that feel good, aware of it all and how your body responds to it, how your breath responds to it, how your mind and your thoughts respond to it. Making your way up to a place that you would like to finish your practice. Maybe that is exactly where you are resting. Bringing your hands to a place of closing, an offering of closing, whatever that may be. Breath in when you're ready. Exhale, drawing your chin down towards your chest, lowering, softening your gaze, or closing your eyes and going inside once more. Aware of it all, the connection down to the earth. How you're feeling, how your body's feeling, sensations, in a dialogue. Move forward into your day with these little bits of awareness every now and again. Thank yourself for being here with a breath in of gratitude and allow that breath to release as you sincerely thank yourself for your practice, for your awareness, for your attention to the details within each moment. From my heart to yours, namaste. Thank you for practicing.